the borders?
The India-Pakistan border. The India-Pakistan border divides the Indian states from the four Pakistani provinces. The border runs from the line of control which separates the Indian-controlled Kashmir from the Pakistani-controlled Kashmir in the north. The border runs from the line of control which separates Indian-controlled Kashmir from the Pakistani side, as well as Wagah, which separates Punjab from the Pakistani side of Punjab. The zero point separates the Indian states of Gujarat and Rajasthan from the Sindh province of Pakistan in the south. Now, drafted and created based upon the Radcliffe line in 1947, the borders which divides Pakistan from India traverses a variety of ranging terrains, from major urban areas to inhospitable deserts, from the Arabian Sea to the naval borders that follows the coast of the Manora Islands of Pakistan all the way to the coast of the Mumbai Harbour. Since the independence of India and Pakistan, the borders have been a site of numerous conflicts and wars between each country. Now, it is considered to be one of the most complex borders in the entire world. The total length of the border is somewhere around 2,900 kilometers or 1,800 miles. Now, according to the figures given by the Public Broadcasting Service, it is also one of the most dangerous borders in the world, as based on an article written in the Foreign Policy Act of 2011. Now, it can be seen from space due to approximately 150,000 floodlights installed by India on about 50,000 poles across the border to counter smuggling and arms trafficking. Now, in 2011, NASA took a photo of the India-Pakistan border that clearly showed the line between two countries lit up, as luminescent as ever. I don't know if you can still see the Great Wall of China as clearly, but you can most definitely see the India-Pakistan border from space. Now, according to the Public Broadcasting Service, the India-Pakistan border in the north has Siachen Glacier, which is one of the second largest glaciers in the world, where temperatures go as low as minus 60 degrees, followed by the Kokaram Range that contains the highest peak, that contains the second highest peak in the world, that is the Kanchenjunga, the K2. Now, going down the border passes through some of the most extreme environments, such as the Thar Desert, where temperatures go as high as about 50 degrees Celsius and minimum rainfall of about 100 millimeters. Now, these borders are guarded by India's special team of border security forces, which was founded in the year 1965 after the Indo-Pakistan War, which revealed the weakness of the Indian border security system and which deemed them delicate. Protecting our borders became a priority, and India established the Border Security Forces, which is the world's largest guarding force with 186 battalions and 2.4 lakh personnel. Now, their motto stands duty unto death. Now, it is the only Indian paramilitary force which has its own marine, air wing, as well as artillery regiments that support the general duty battalions. Now, the Border Security Forces also has their own separate camel and dog wings that let them expand their reach into a variety of terrain as well as threatened situations. Now, the Border Security Forces also runs a national level dog breeding and training facility that they have called the National Training Centers for Dogs, which trains canines experts in infantry patrolling, detection of explosives, as well as tracking. The founding father and the first general of Border Security Forces was K.F. Rustamji from the Indian Police Services. The BSF has access to special all-terrain vehicles for their personnel in the run of Kutch. These up the monitors about 4,000 kilometers of inhospitable terrain in Gujarat. They have an elite force called the Creek Commando Force that mans the hostile creek of the park bordering Gujarat. Now trained to endure the harshest environments, these might as well be India's super soldiers. The Border Security Forces that conducts the Wagah border ceremony is also deemed one of the most prestigious parts of the Indian Border Security Force. The essential component of the BSF has been one that has been broadcasted throughout India in numerous occasions, and their capability of handling situations and dealing with threats that have been utilized at the border itself has been countless times appreciated and commended. Now, this is something that is very prestigious to the nation. And with the threat of rising terror throughout the planet, it is very essential that we do have someone that we know and believe that can protect us in the scenario in which we are attacked at the border. Now, taking a step back from the topic, I would like to give you guys my personal opinion. Being someone who believes in a globalist ideology, borders aren't really something that I'm pretty okay with. Now, I completely understand the requirement of borders, and that's why I respect the fact that they are there, that they exist and they're active. But would I believe that there could be a world, or there can be a world where none of these lines that we drew on the planet are significant anymore? Yes, I do. As a matter of fact, optimism is something that there is pretty less of on the planet. There's a lot that goes down on the face of the planet that we aren't really aware of. From the stuff that is going down as of now, the one thing that we do know is if we are on the face of nuclear war, there is nothing that can stop it. The only thing that can is we hope and pray that the people who are in the decision-making spot come to their senses and realize that that is not the way to go. Apart from that, there isn't really much that we can do. But we can do something. And that is, in the scenario in which we have a future to look forward to, why not ensure that that future is different from the one that we are forced to be in as of now? When we look back, everyone thought 2000s is going to be the breakthrough years of humanity. By the year 2020, we were supposed to be a race that's flying around in jet-powered vehicles in the air. Complete fusion, deep space, a whole lot of research, cancer treatments, immortality, too far-fetched, but still. These were concepts that we could be discussing as of now if the whole point of having borders and the whole point of people looking out for only their half of the planet could go away. Consider the fact that if there was one government, if there was one planet, and it was all of us together working towards one cause, and that's humanity, working towards making sure that our race is the best that it can be, I believe we would have made leaps in progress. By now, we would have been one of the most advanced species in the universe. Maybe. At least we would know for sure where is intelligent life, if there is any. At least we would be able to answer certain questions for sure. At least we would have better green energy. There are a lot of things that were held back because of the fact that we couldn't get rid of these lines that we drew a long time ago. I understand that back then they were essential to the very fact that humanity existed and humanity thrived throughout cultures that basically meant to wipe out entire tribes because of the fact that there were these lines that were drawn. There were a lot of places that could sustain themselves, save their history, their culture. But it still begs me to answer the question. Is there a time where we can look at where none of this gets in the way anymore? Yes, it had a place in its time, but now, I guess it's a thought worth keeping, the thought worth processing. Peace.